Hi, welcome back to Harbour Under Below. I've got some more storage from eBay, second hand of course, came with various components. Four drawers were missing out of them. Got all these plus more storage. Some of the drawers got a little bit of break on the drawers as well, so let's fix this issue today. So I've got the little drawer here, just use my calipers there, I'll measure out all the sizes. Transfer that to the computer using Fusion 360. On the design as well, it's got a little V shape for the tags in here. I'll be going for a square shape rather than a V shape. Just make things a little simpler for myself to use. I can do it in Fusion 360, but there you go. These little tags were made using my Cricut machine and a pen and the cutting facilities on them. Really make them look very good. So I'll take over to the PC and let you see Fusion 360 how I design them. So in Fusion 360, I start off using a drawing. Now I do apologise in advance, folks, about the noise of the rain. I do stay in Scotland and it is a torrential today. I've just done a basic two squares for the base and the walls. I then extrude the walls up and also at the base. Next, I do another bits and pieces there, putting in the drawing for the drawer handle and put a bit of chamfer around some of the corners and edges as well. The box, and put a sketch on top of it and draw the little hole for the, where the drawers go down. Strictly speaking, this not necessarily what to do this here. I did have a little issue with this chamfer in here with the drawing, so rather than do it in the drawing, I done it in the 3D space using the chamfer command. So putting in more chamfers as we go around as well, little holes and things like that, just to tidy things up. And then I put in this little sketch to put in the little grooves for the card to sit in these parts here. I said again, I could have put it at an angle, but I opted to just go straight on down. Saves a bit of time in the Cricut as well, rather than trying to do things at an angle. And they don't fall out as much as I've discovered with the original design. So I said again, a little bit of chamfers, and that's us. And then I'd go up to my model there, right click it, then go up to the components, select that, right click, and save as a mesh. That'll allow me to save as a mesh, click OK, and I'd save it to my designated file. The moment it's my desktop. So we'll go over to the Cura 5. I'll show you how it's sliced. This is Cura 5, a little slicer for the Ender. I've got my printer set up here, and I've got a standard setting here, 0.2 millimeters. I click on top of that, I go down there, my material temperature, for example, is 200 degrees Celsius, my build plate temperature is 200 degrees Celsius. That's just set for the material that I use, PLA. We did this support as well. I've generated support there, tick the everywhere button, put everywhere on top of it, and also put in tree rather than just general support, like using the tree. Bold plate adhesion is a skirt, it just draws a line right about the model before it starts printing. So if I slice that now, you'll be surprised the time it takes to print this model. And it's 5 hours 58 minutes, just short of 66 hours. So I go up here and change the quality to it. For example, I take it down to 0.12 millimeters. Keep the changes and slice again. You start to see the better quality you get. It takes a lot longer, nearly 10 hours with that one. If I did take it down to very low quality, 2.2 mm, which is more than enough for a workshop ready kit. Slice again. It comes down to 4 hours, 22 minutes. There is another way you can speed up the model as well, but I'm still working on top of that. So I'll go to preview. I'll let you see the model, how it prints out there. There you can see the tree effect. The handles at the front end, and I'm trying to do supports all the way up there. So I'll go across the printer there. I did do my print in 2 millimeters, 0.2 millimeters, is to say, the standard quality, rather than anything else. So I'll let you see the print coming out, hopefully catch it before it finishes printing off. 6 hours is a long time to sit and wait to try and catch something filming. I haven't worked out the total cost yet, but it's not an expensive printer to run. The elements are quite small. I did check the smart meter and it says that they run at 6 pence per minute. And with the household electrics, fridge on, etc, etc, you take a few pence off that as well. So, not too bad. As it just finishes. And a little bit of moulding as well, a little support on the things as well. So I'll let it cool down and I'll take them back off and let you see it. Well, this drawer's printed there, folks. I've took off the support. There's a little bit of rough bit here. I can give it a little file if required. The nameplate fits in quite nice as well. And the drawer's fitting perfectly. So I'll let you see the finished product and the photograph before we go. I say again, you get a little fill with it, you can paint it. It's not clear, but hey, it's for holding components on a layout. It's not exactly going to be seen by the public, it's only seen by myself, and it serves a function. On the cost wise, the print and the electricity, etc., etc., I reckon it's about 10 pence per box. So, on the whole, not too bad. Hope you liked watching, folks. Please like, subscribe. We'll catch you again in the next one. Cheers.